Hi dear students, welcome to Ardent MDS. The topic what we are going to see about gonococci, and till now the last two sessions we studied about gram positive cocci. Staphylococci and streptococci are gram positive cocci. Now we are going to see about gram negative cocci. Example for gram negative cocci are Neisseria gonococci and Neisseria meningococci. Let's start with the gonococci. So we have to know the basic difference between meningococci and gonococci, right? So even though it is discussed in the previous session about meningococci, we just go for a fast recap of the difference between meningococci and gonococci here too. So in meningococci, which ferment both maltose and glucose, but gonococci which ferment only glucose. So this is the basic test for something called as RCUT, rapid carbohydrate utilization test. That is a biochemical test which is used to differentiate meningococci and gonococci. If it is only ferment glucose, that is gonococci. Gonococci has only G, but meningococci, just see, it has both M and G. So that's why it is maltose and glucose. And what is the shape of the meningococci? Shape of the meningococci is lens. Gonococci has shape of kidney. Right. And number three, meningococci has capsule. Gonococci does not have capsule. Non-capsulated. Number four, here there is no plasmids. But gonococci has plasmids. This plasmids which is responsible for the resistance mechanism of gonococci to the antibiotics. So these are some of the basic difference between meningococci and gonococci. Meningococci which causes meningitis, gonococci which causes gonorrhea. Right, coming to the virulence factors of gonococci. Just remember this mnemonic, IPLO. Okay. In case of a meningococci, it is Ciplo because it does not have capsule. Just remember the virulence factor as Ciplo. And I for IgA1 protease. And P for pili. Pili which is helps for the addition of the microorganisms. And L for lipooligosaccharide. It is not lipopolysaccharide, it is lipooligosaccharide. Just remember this. O for outer membrane protein, right? So outer membrane protein is nothing but the pili complex all together called as outer membrane protein. And one more O is opacity associated protein. Opacity associated protein. So simple way to remember is just IPLO, IgA1 protease, and P for pili, L for lipooligosaccharide, O for opacity associated protein or outer membrane protein. That's it. And coming to the very important part about the clinical manifestation of the Neisseria gonococci. So most common manifestation in males, and it is a sexual transmitted disease, you know very well. So that's why it is most common manifestation in males, acute urethritis. Is the most common manifestation. The complication, this acute urethritis, if it is not treated, so this leads to multiple periurethral discharge, which have some sinus. So this multiple periurethral discharge, otherwise called as water can perineum. It's called as water can perineum. Coming to the most common manifestation in females, cervicitis is the most common manifestation in females. And coming to the children's, but in case of this, before that you have to know this, in case of it is a pregnant female, okay, this infection gonococci which transmitted to the child during the birth, so this leads to infection of the eye, called as ophthalmia neonatorum, which is very important clinical manifestation for the child or for the neonate. For the neonate, the most common manifestation is ophthalmia neonatorum, which is transmitted from the mother. Coming to the children's, children I am talking about pre-pubertal girls and post-menopausal women. Okay, for those, the most common manifestation is vulvovaginitis. Vulvovaginitis is not a very common manifestation in a adult female. Adult female, it is not a common manifestation, but it is seen in only pre-pubertal girls and post-menopausal women. There is a reason for this, because in a adult, vagina is, the pH is more of acidic and it has a high thickness stratified squamous epithelium. So because of the low pH and thickness of the stratified squamous epithelium, adult vagina is resistant to the gonococci. But it is more common in pre-pubertal girl and post-menopausal woman. Right. And one more the complication about gonococci is Fitz-Hugh-Hattie syndrome. So what is this? Fitz-Hugh-Hattie syndrome. If it is not treated, it will spread through peritoneal route and it causes inflammation around the liver. So inflammation around the liver, that is perihepatitis, which is called as Fitz-Hugh-Hattie syndrome. Right, let's see the how it look like, because these days there are many of picture based questions asked in your NEET exam or INSET exam. So these pictures are very important. So the most common manifestation in males is urethritis. Most common manifestation in females, cervicitis. Right. And this is the most common manifestation in neonates, which affects the eye. It's called as ophthalmia neonatorum. Right. And this is, which is seen in males, if it is not treated, just called as multiple periurethral discharge. So this multiple periurethral discharge, which is called as water can perineum. This is again asked in very commonly, water can perineum in males. And this is called as perihepatitis, that is Fitz-Hugh-Hattie syndrome. And what is his appearance? So you may get a question, what is the appearance seen in Fitz-Hugh-Hattie syndrome? If you see, it looks like something violin string, right? Violin string appearance seen in perihepatitis, that is Fitz-Hugh-Hattie syndrome. Coming to the laboratory diagnosis. So the most common smear or successful smear in case of female, it is taken from endocervical area. Endocervical area, you have to collect the smear, number one, in case of females. In case of a males, you can go for urethral discharge, either spontaneously or doing the prostate massage, you will get the urethral discharge. And this diagnosis or the culturing of the gonococci should be done very immediately, otherwise the gonococci does not survive. So if you want to transport to some other laboratory, you can use a transport medium. So example for the transport medium of gonococci is Stewart medium. So this is again one of the very important MCQ. Stewart medium is the transport medium. What is the transport medium for streptococci? Pikes medium. So here it is a Stewart medium, clear. But in case, if it is transported to the distance, you have to, or for a longer holding period, you have to use a medium which is called as carbon dioxide generating medium or carbon dioxide generating system, which is called as, the name of this is called GEMPEC. One of the example for this is GEMPEC, that is carbon dioxide generating medium or system. So for longer holding period, we can use this. So these are the important things which you can use. And what is the selective medium for the gonococci? So transport medium is Stewart medium. What is the selective medium? MCQ. Thayer Martin medium is the selective medium. But you can use chocolate agar also for the gonococci. Right. But the selective medium is Thayer Martin. What is for this transport medium? Stewart medium. Clear. What is the treatment? Treatment for gonococcus, third generation cephalosporin. But nowadays, the microorganisms are what even resistant to this third generation cephalosporin. The reason is the resistant mechanism occurs through plasmids. Also, chromosomal mediated transmit mechanism or resistant mechanism which occurs in gonococci. So these are the various important points which you have to know. Coming to the very important golden points, the best site to obtain swab in asymptomatic gonorrhea is endocervical area is the best site. Virulence factor for gonococci are, just now we studied IPLO, IgA1 protease, pili, opacity associated protein, lipo-oligosaccharide. Water canperineum is caused by gonococci, that is around the urethral, will have periurethral discharge which is called as water canperineum in gonococci. Deficiency of which complement factor? In case of a deficiency of complement factor, so that too late complement factor. Late complement is C5 to C9. So it is used for forming a something called as membrane attack complex. So in case of deficiency of this factor, which leads to susceptibility to the gonococci and meningococci. Resistant to antimicrobial agent in gonococci is due to both plasmid and chromosomal mediated. What is the incubation period for gonorrhea? 2 to 7 days is the incubation period. And what is the selective medium? Thayer Martin medium. Gonococci is predominantly, this is one of the very important questions. Gonococci is predominantly intracellular organism. It also present in extracellular, but is predominantly it is an intracellular. But what about meningococci? Meningococci is predominantly extracellular microorganisms. And all these things which are simplified and given in here, Alden Flash, here I explained about the differences between meningococci and gonococci and about selective medium, Thayer Martin medium and transport medium is Stewart medium. And most the gonococci is the most common cause for pelvic inflammatory disease. Okay, but if they ask you throughout the worldwide, but in India, if they ask, it is tuberculosis. It also the most common cause for septic arthritis. It also causes most severe form of ophthalmia neonatorum. So these are some more important MCQs which you have to know here. And clinical feature in case of males, it is acute urethritis, female cervicitis, pregnant women, salpingitis, neonates, ophthalmia neonatorum, children's vulvovaginitis. Fitzhugh-Hertie syndrome is about perihepatic inflammation, perihepatitis. Diagnosis is by gram staining of the urethral discharge. You have to do the process immediately because gonococci are susceptible to the drying. And the treatment is about third generation cephalosporins. These are some of the important points which you have to know related to the gonococci. And let's work out some of the multiple choice questions related to the gonococci. The most common gonorrheal infection in females, answer is cervicitis. Most common gonorrheal infection in male is urethritis. In case of neonates, ophthalmia neonatorum, children, vulvovaginitis. So you can go for the fourth option. Next is about a clinical based question. So let's find out some important key points here. A male, 25-year-old male, which has an urethral discharge, first key point, and dysuria for the previous 2 days, history of the unprotected sex with a commercial sex workers with a week back. So this is a second key point. Incubation period for gonococci is around 2 to 7 days. An examination of a smear of pus, it is a gram negative diplococci. This is a very important key point. Culture in Thayer Martin medium, the next key point. So very easy question, right? So gram negative cocci is only meningococci and gonococci. So here they're talking about urethral discharge. So what will be your answer? Neisseria gonococci, very easy question. True about Neisseria gonorrhea. So it is a kidney shaped organism. Meningococci is lens shaped microorganism. Again, easy question. Gonococci can be identified by the fermentation of the glucose, but meningococci, which causes fermentation of both maltose and glucose, which is called as rapid carbohydrate utilization test, which is used for both gonococci and meningococci, right? All the following are features of gonococci except, so they are talking about which is not a feature of gonococci, right? So it is a non-capsulated, so it is a correct sentence. Ferment both glucose and maltose, so it is a wrong one. It is a kidney shaped, right? It is a gram positive, it is a gram negative, so it is a wrong statement. Is it lens shaped? No, it is a kidney shape, so it is also a wrong statement. So what will be your answer? 2, 4, 5 are the wrong statements. You can go for first option. Coming to the statement 1, gonorrheal infection which spread to the periurethral disease, which produces multiple discharge sinus, which is called as water can perineum. Yes, correct. Fitzher-Curtis syndrome is perihepatic inflammation. Yes, this is also right. So what will be your answer? Both statements are true. So hope this video about gonococci is very useful for you. Thank you for watching.